Prague is the capital and the largest city of the Czech Republic. The historical capital of Bohemia is one of Europe's finest cities and a major Czech economic and cultural center. Prague is home to about 1.3 million people, while its metropolitan area is estimated to have a population of 2.7 million. Home to a number of well-known cultural attractions, Prague is one of the most visited European cities. The historic center of Prague has been included in the UNESCO list of World Heritage Sites and today is a popular tourist destination. Stay tuned to find more interesting stuff about Prague and its main tourist attractions. The Czech name Praha is derived from an old Slavic word, Prah, which means ford or rapid, referring to the city's origin at the crossing point of the Vltava River. The region where today is Prague was settled as early as the Paleolithic Age. Celts had settlements in the region from about 500 to 200 BC. From the 4th to the 6th century AD, Slavs appeared on the Vltava banks, followed by the Avars. The legendary origins of Prague attribute its foundation to the 8th century Czech duchess and prophetess Libuše and her husband Přemysl, founder of the Přemysl dynasty. Legend says that Libuše came out on a rocky cliff high above the Vltava and prophesied, "I see a great city whose glory will touch the stars." She ordered a castle and a town called Praha to be built on the site. The construction of what came to be known as Prague Castle began near the end of the 9th century, expanding a fortified settlement that had existed on the site since the year 800. The region became the seat of the dukes and later kings of Bohemia. Under Holy Roman Emperor Otto II, the area became a bishopric in 973. The economic expansion of the community was reflected in the topography of the city. A market center on the right bank developed into the old town, particularly after the construction of the first stone bridge, the Judith Bridge, over the river in 1170. By 1230, the old town had been given borough status and was defended by a system of walls and fortifications. Prague flourished during the reign of Charles IV, Holy Roman Emperor and the King of Bohemia of the new Luxembourg dynasty. In 1348, he founded Charles University, the first in Central Europe, which was later to attract scholars and students from throughout the continent. As King of Bohemia and Holy Roman Emperor, he transformed Prague into an imperial capital, and it was at that time, by the area, the third largest city in Europe, after Rome and Constantinople. Jan Hus, a theologian and rector at the Charles University, preached in Prague. Having become too dangerous for the political and religious establishment, Hus was put on trial for heresy and burned at the stake in Constance in 1415. Popular uprisings in 1419, led by the Prague priest Jan Jelewski, included the throwing of city councillors from the windows of the new town hall in the incident known as the First Defenestration of Prague. The Second Defenestration of Prague took place in 1618, when the governors of Bohemia were thrown from the windows of the council room in Hradčany, leading to the 30 Years' War. This was followed by the decisive defeat of Protestant forces at the Battle of the White Mountain near the city in 1620. The city ceased to be the capital of the empire, was occupied by Saxons in 1631 and Swedes in 1648, and went into a decline accelerated by two outbreaks of plague. The economy of Prague improved during the 18th century. The population increased to 80,000 inhabitants by 1771. Many rich merchants and nobles enhanced the city with a host of palaces, churches, and gardens full of art and music, creating a Baroque city famous throughout the world to this day. In 1918, after the defeat of Austria-Hungary, Prague became the capital of the newly independent Czechoslovak Republic. By 1930, the population had reached 850,000 inhabitants. The city suffered a setback following its occupation by Germany in March 1939. The citizens rose in revolt on the 5th of May 1945 and held the city until the Red Army arrived 4 days later. In November 1989, the Velvet Revolution crowded the streets of Prague, ending 4 decades of communist rule in Czechoslovakia. When Czechoslovakia itself was dissolved into its constituent republics on January 1, 1993, Prague maintained its prominent international status as capital of the Czech Republic. From 1995, high-rise buildings began to be built in Prague in large quantities. In the late 1990s, Prague again became an important cultural center of Europe and was notably influenced by globalization. Prague is situated on the Vltava River in the center of the Bohemian Basin. The lowest point in the city is 190 meters above sea level and the highest point is 380 meters on White Mountain. Prague has an oceanic climate with continental influences and temperatures are averaging 20 degrees Celsius in July and 0 degrees Celsius in January. Now, let's talk about the main tourist attractions in Prague. The Prague Castle, once the home of the Bohemia's kings, is today the official residence of the Czech Republic's president and one of the city's most visited tourist attractions. Originally built as a walled fortress around 870 AD, the castle had changed dramatically over the years and contains examples of most of the leading architectural styles of the last millennium. It was completed only in 1929. Within the castle walls are a number of Prague's most popular tourist sites, including St. Vitus Cathedral, St. George's Basilica, the Powder Tower, the Old Royal Palace, and the Golden Lane. According to the Guinness Book of Records, the Prague Castle is the largest ancient castle in the world. The Roman Catholic St. Vitus Cathedral is the Czech Republic's largest and most important Christian church. Seat of the Archbishop of Prague, it's also home to the tombs of numerous saints and 3 Bohemian kings. Founded on the site of a Romanos Rotunda, built in 925 AD, the cathedral was started in 1344 and took more than 525 years to complete, resulting in a mix of modern Neo-Gothic and 14th century Gothic styles, along with Baroque and Renaissance influences. Charles Bridge is one of the most recognizable old bridges in Europe. Finished in 1402, Charles Bridge was the most important connection between Prague Castle and the city's old town and neighboring areas until 1841. The bridge is particularly famous for its many fine old statues. Other highlights include spectacular views over the river Vltava and the structure's superb Gothic gates. The historic center of Prague, the old town, is where you'll find the splendid Old Town Square, situated between Wenceslas Square and the Charles Bridge. Here you'll find the Tin Church and the Clementinum, along with numerous other fine old churches, as well as splendid old architecture dating back as far as the 11th century. Prague Orloj is a medieval astronomical clock mounted on the old town hall. The clock was first installed in 1410, making it the 3rd oldest astronomical clock in the world and the oldest one still in operation. The Tin Church is a Gothic church with 2 80-meter high towers and each tower spire is topped by 8 smaller spires in 2 layers of 4. Another beautiful church in the old town is St. Nicholas Church. This is a late Gothic and Baroque church built between 1732 to 1737 on the site of a Gothic church from the 13th century which was also dedicated to St. Nicholas. The Wenceslas Square is one of the main city squares and the center of the business and cultural communities in the new town. Many historical events occurred there and it is a traditional setting for demonstrations, celebrations and other public gatherings. It is also the place with the busiest pedestrian traffic in the whole country. Here is located the National Museum and numerous other architectural treasures like Grand Hotel Europa and Corona Palace. The Prague Municipal House is widely considered one of the finest examples of Art Nouveau in the city. Built in 1912, this splendid civic building is also home to one of Prague's most important concert venues, Smetana Hall. It is located next to the Powder Gate in the center of the city. The Powder Gate, also known as Powder Tower, is one of the original city gates and it separates the old town from the new town. The National Theatre is idyllically perched on the banks of the River Vltava and is a must visit for lovers of the performing arts. Home to the country's top opera, ballet and drama performances, the National Theatre was opened in 1881 as a symbol of Czech national identity and to promote the Czech language and culture. The Rudolfinov is a building designed in the neo-Renaissance style and is situated on Jan Palach Square on the bank of the River Vltava. It was opened in 1885 and currently the Czech Philharmonic Orchestra and Gallery Rudolfinum are based in the building. The Dancing House is Prague's most outstanding modern architectural creation and was built between 1992 and 1996. Consisting of two adjoining towers, this splendid structure features unique curves that resemble two dancing figures, an effect heightened by the fact one of the towers is shaped like a woman wearing a skirt. I hope you enjoyed our video. If you know other interesting tourist attractions in Prague, please leave a comment about them. If you want to see more interesting videos, help our channel to grow by pressing the like button and share our videos with your friends. And if you are the first time here, don't forget to subscribe.